Stephen Holt, and you'll never guess where the Stephen Holt Show is this week. We're in Newport, Rhode Island. Yes, we are. We're in Newport. We've never been here before. I went to the University of Rhode Island, and you get off the train at Kingston, and you come over the couple of bridges here to Newport. And when I was in school, they didn't even have those bridges. Then you had to take ferries. So I never really experienced Newport until now. It's just gorgeous, and we're staying at the Hydrangea House Inn, which is just gorgeous here on the Main Street Bellevue here in Newport. Yes, it's really called Bellevue. And over there is where the Newport Film Festival is going to be. Of course, you know, I wouldn't be just doing travel without having entertainment too. It's the 6th annual Newport Film Festival is going to start any minute now, and we're right across the street at the gay-owned and operated Hydrangea House. So anyway, let's go and get this on the road. Oh, here's the owner, Daisy. Hey, Daisy. No, her name isn't Daisy, it's Rosie. All right. Well, hi! Are you Dennis?
Surprised I am.
Hey Dennis, Stephen Holt. You're the owner and operator of the Select Registry of North America, the Hydrangea House. And it's so gorgeous. Is this Hydrangea? Is that what this color is?
This is aubergine.
Aubergine, one of my favorite colors here. So, may we come in
please
and
come
give
in,
us
yes.
a tour?
Welcome.
Okay, we're gonna, and that was Rosie.
Rosie.
Our co-star will be joining us too in a minute. All right, come on in. Okay, well now I'm so excited because I'm actually here in the beautiful, beautiful Hydrangea House. I love that name, and you won't forget this name. It's a bed and breakfast, my favorite kind of place to stay when you're really going to somewhere and you really want to soak up all the local color. And there's plenty of color, and it's all my favorite colors. Here is a rainbow at the Hydrangea House, and we're here with Dennis Blair and Grant Edmondson, the owners.
Welcome.
Hey, how long have you two been together?
21 years.
22.
It's congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations.
Our record.
How did we meet?
Your record?
Our record, yes.
You've got a record coming
out?
No, wait a minute.
No.
The CD is in the store soon.
Not that kind of record.
Two gentlemen that stayed with us 58 years.
Oh,
yeah, it was really exciting.
There's a lot of history. Long time partnerships that come to stay with us. Mm-hmm. A lot.
Well, that's my audience.
Yeah, that's wonderful. A long time. I'm 20 years. We're like in the mid range for there's newbies. There's guys just getting started and women as well.
And straight people here too. Yep. I'm the only gay person in the building besides them. So straight people can come here too. But another important point about Newport, it's the kind of place where couples can come, as you've mentioned, you know, gay men of an âge certain, can come and feel safe.
Absolutely.
And comfortable.
Absolutely.
In Newport at the Hydrangea House.
That's right.
Okay, let's go on the tour.
Okay.
So, this is the beautiful dining room. It looks like Versailles.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yeah, it's a great space.
The chandelier. I love having breakfast with a chandelier.
Thank you. It came in a great big box. Couldn't get it through the door.
Ah!
I had to pack it on the street and carry it in. It was quite a big box, but we finally got it home.
And these candelabras are quite
well. The candlesticks. That's our Harry Potter look. We think. It's
okay.
They're, the heat in the room has kind of done this over the years, and we just love them and whimsical, and guests love them and always want to take them home. So we've kept them.
Oh, okay. I know they look like they're growing in here.
Exactly.
And now, through the magic of television, Grant has disappeared and suddenly been replaced by Dennis. But we're not going to tell you how we did that. It was the trick of the eye. But Dennis, what beautiful room are we in now?
Well, this is the Carrie in Paris suite. And
Carrie in Paris.
That's
okay.
Correct.
And who is Carrie?
Well, Carrie Bradshaw from Sex and the City. Who else?
Oh! Duh, I should have known. That was a trick question. So all your rooms are named after different Sex and the City episodes?
No, actually not. This was really a first venture that we took the theme from one of those shows. Actually, I think the third from the last, when she was in Paris with that awful Russian man. They were at the Four Seasons, actually filming in one of their suites, and it was all these colors, you know, the periwinkle blue, the gold and the yellows and the reds, and it went. We were watching a rerun of it on HBO. Can I say that? HBO. And I was asleep. It was around midnight, and Grant says, "Wake up, wake up! This is our new room. Look at it. It's beautiful." And by the time I woke up, the scene was over. So I assume this is what it looked like, because I never did
see
the
show.
So
you did this before or after you saw the episode?
We did this after we saw the episode.
Oh!
Because we were actually, at the time, we were doing renovations and we were trying to think of what to do with each room. And so he says, let's do that room that was on Sex and the City.
Hey!
And
hey!
She
oh, she hates me. Hey! Hey! Rosie!
So that's what we did.
Oh, okay! Rosie. Oh, well. I hate animals. Anyway. Hey, Rosie. Hey. Are we on?
Yep.
Oh, through the magic of TV, Rosie found Grant. Here he is again. Oh, jeez. My laugh is driving her wild. Okay. This is where I'm staying. Can you believe it with this? Yes, it is. There's so much room in it that this is five times the size of my New York, or most New York apartments. And of course, the grand staircase over here leading up to, what is the name of this room? I don't even know.
This is the Chesterfield room.
The Chesterfield, named after the cigarettes?
Well, at the time we had a sofa that was the Chesterfield style and it kept the name.
It kept the name.
Yeah. We struggle for names. Sometimes we name them after the wallpaper design.
Well, you can have the Stephen Holt room.
There we go.
The Quentin Crisp room.
We could do that.
You could do
well,
the Oscar Wilde room.
Just make your mark.
Well, this is just so good. I mean, this is the kind of room you dream about when you think the Stephen Holt show's going on the road, and oh my goodness, I mean, to wake up in a canopy bed with on this that the mattress was like sleeping on a cloud, really. It was. It really
we spent a lot of money on our mattresses purposely because we wanted
mm-hmm.
the guests to be very well rested. Newport's a big walking town. Everyone wants to be on their feet in this town.
And you can get around by
everywhere.
Walking here. You
everywhere.
Don't necessarily need a car,
that's
which our
right.
New York viewers, this is a very good
And you know the one thing
point.
About New Yorkers, if they do want to rent a car, I'd recommend, they don't have one in New York, I'd recommend taking the train up to
Kingston.
New Haven or Stanford. Renting a car there for a third of the price of what it would be to rent a car in New York. It is so simple, you're off the train at the station and the car rental agencies are right there for your benefit. Very, very simple to do.
Not driving, I never would think of these
things.
Yeah,
but then drive from Stanford up to Newport. It's a very nice drive and coming through coastal areas in Rhode Island is very, very nice.
Well, I tell you, not having been really in Newport before,
mm-hmm.
every building here is beautiful.
It's
and
wonderful.
Scenic. It's just a knockout architecturally. And we're not even on the Mansion Row or Cliff Walk or whatever.
Exactly.
We're,
Bellevue Avenue is Mansion Row.
Oh, it is? Oh,
we're
are.
On the north end in the town section.
Yes.
And the mansions are just a short stroll,
but
5 minute walk.
You said that this was a famous literary area. This was an artist and writer.
Yeah,
writers,
in the days of when, Grant? Clement Moore and...
The Night Before Christmas was written just around the corner from us.
Oh, so that's why the Hydrangea house feels so Christmassy.
There you are.
It's sort of built into the foundation of the building.
Yeah.
And this, I have to tell you, this gigantic jacuzzi
it is.
Last night was just the perfect thing after a long train trip on Amtrak from New York to Kingston. We were met and brought here
mm-hmm.
by the Convention and Visitors Bureau.
They're very great
right.
people.
Yeah, and they love all their clients, and they love the city. And this was quite an adventure. And there's two showers in one the bathroom.
Shower, yes.
Yeah.
Again. So bring your significant other next time.
It's a dream come true.
Have fun.
Any way you slice it,
good
right?
Yeah.